Now I will show you how to pre-crystallize chocolate. I have here melted chocolate, as I already explained to you, so very liquid, very shiny, very glossy. That's a visual indication that my chocolate is really melted. So what I will do, I will just have to drop the temperature for dark chocolates around 32 degrees centigrade, and I will mix a little bit of chocolate. This is really important because if you just leave the chocolate like this for a few days, all the dry particles just drop to the bottom, all the light particles just go on top of it. So it means cocoa butter, you will have a layer of cocoa butter on top of the chocolate. Before you want to, or you have to start, or you want to start to pre-crystallize the chocolate, you have to stir well. It's very important that the chocolate is just really well mixed together. Okay? Now, what I will do, I will drop it on the marble. I do it like this. Pay attention, keep it high enough, and I will try to drop as much as I can. So if I do that, I will not have to over-crystallize the chocolate, because I don't have, look, I don't almost have nothing melted, let's say, in my kettle. So you clean the edge, of course, with a clean finger, not with the tongue, of course. Another visual thing is that here, you can see that you have different colors. Here it's a little bit darker instead of here. How darker the chocolate is, how cooler it is. I can show you. I will take some chocolate and I will just drop it like a line on this place here, on this pale part of the chocolate. And you will see the line will be darker. So take a look. You see, we have a dark line now. So because here the chocolate is cooling down, so that's really a visual indication also that chocolate becomes cooler. Especially with the dark chocolate, of course, you can see it better. Okay, I will do actually the same what I did with my cocoa butter. So I will remove it on the marble. And as you can see here, the chocolate is very liquid. You see that? It's floating open. That's also an indication that chocolate still melted. Okay, I will remove it using a palette knife and a scraper. And, of course, as I already told you, movement is very important to pre-crystallize this quantity of chocolate. It's not only this part that I have to remove, I have to remove everything. So, don't be afraid to do that. Very important is that palette knife here. You see, I can use my palette knife to clean my scraper. Look well, if I don't do that, if I don't use my palette knife, I have a lot of pieces of chocolate that stays behind here. This will set very fast, of course, because it's a small quantity of chocolate. And when I mix this all together, I will have a lot of lumps in my chocolate. So that's then the problem, that I have to stir longer to make it smooth, okay, after pre-crystallization. Pre-crystallization is, as we also say, tempering. But tempering is actually more related to temperature. Is that pre-crystallization is actually a visual thing. You can see that after a while the chocolate will start to become thicker. Okay? You could use a thermometer, but it's not really necessary. Once that you see that it becomes thicker, that's for you okay to know that your chocolate is crystallized. Pre-crystallization is also a matter of feeling. I can already feel that there is a little bit more resistance. So that's an indication that your chocolate really starts to crystallize. Also here, I can feel that your chocolate starts to become thicker, especially here on this scraper, because it is always in contact with the marble, where of course the chocolate will set a little bit quicker. This is already an indication that I have to put it back in the kettle. How do I do that? I just take a small table, a tray, I put the kettle here, and then I scrape it as quick as possible back into the kettle. As you also can see, the chocolate is still liquid. Don't forget that here I'm using a couverture. What's a couverture? A couverture contains more than 31% total fat content. For dark chocolate, is it of course only cocoa butter. But this one contains a little bit more. It's about 40%. So very liquid. So we scrape well the table, put all the chocolate back into the kettle. Clean well the table. Just put it back into the kettle, the melting kettle. What I can do is cleaning my tools just with a scraper. Try to avoid water, because if you're going to use water and you will add water to your chocolate, the chocolate will thicken very quick. So don't do that. Just scrape well the table. And all these are crystals. So we just add it to the chocolate. Okay. I just take my spoon and stir well. Stirring is very important, because now I have to really mix well, because there is a part that is crystallized and another part, is a very small part, is non-crystallized, still warm. So if I don't mix well, I will have a lot of lines and stripes. If you see that the chocolate is looking quite liquid, then it's possible that you don't have enough crystallization. So then you have to drop again a small part of the quantity of your chocolate back on the marble, remove again, pre-crystallize it again, and then add it to the rest of your chocolate. Here I can already see that for sure I have crystals. You can see that the chocolate is a little bit thicker. That's an indication that the chocolate is crystallized. Of course, I still have some lumps here. When you see that, we have to heat it up. What do? I just raise the temperature until the lights go on, because this is an indication that the resistance here is working. What is written here on the thermostat is not important. Just look at the chocolate. This is more important, because the thermostat is related to the temperature and not to the crystals. So this chocolate will tell you the truth, not the thermostat. So when I see that the chocolate is a little bit thicker, I can use a heating gun after I have raised the temperature, and I will heat the chocolate very fast. Pay attention. This has a temperature around 500 degrees centigrade. So if I heat up the chocolate like this on the surface, it will burn very fast. So pay attention. You have to keep the chocolate in movement and just melt a part of the crystal. Not everything, because if you melt everything, we speak again about melted chocolate, not crystallized chocolate. So stir well. You will feel also, and you will also see that the chocolate becomes more liquid. Okay, now I can see that the chocolate is just a little bit thicker then it was melted. So this is for me an indication that the chocolate is crystallized. You can see it is still liquid, but just a little bit thicker. To be sure that your chocolate is really crystallized, you can take a sample. Just take a palette knife, a piece of paper, a plastic scraper. You just add a little bit of chocolate on top of the palette knife, and you just wait a few minutes to let set this chocolate. If it's not setting, if it's not becomes hard, if there is no beautiful shine, then it means that your chocolate is not well pre-crystallized. If it sets very fast, could be an indication that your chocolate is lightly over-crystallized. Of course, pay attention with the room temperature. The room temperature is usually around 20 degrees centigrade. This will give you really a good indication for the controlling or to control the crystallization for your chocolate. This is the part of the sample. As you can see, I put some chocolate on this palette knife just to control if I still have a good crystallization, if my chocolate is well pre-crystallized. And you can see here that there is a really beautiful gloss. The chocolate is really hard, so that's really a good indication that the chocolate is well pre-crystallized.